Hello friends, welcome to CrackIt CSE. So in this series of database, today we will be understanding join operation in relational algebra. So there are join operations. Join operations are divided in three categories. One is natural join, other one is conditional join, and third one is outer join. So we will be understanding all these three joins and the subcategories of these joins. So without wasting time, let's start with the join definition. What is a join? So join is a combination of Cartesian product, that is a cross product we can say, with some selection operation. So join operation can be performed with the help of Cartesian product and selection operator. So a join operation pairs two tuple from different relation if and only if a given condition is satisfied. That means if we are having two relation R and S, then there has to be some condition on the basis of which we can join R and S tuples. Let's see the natural join. So in natural join, we will be joining R with S. It can be written as project pi select R cross X. Here will be having condition of equality. In R join S, the condition is by default equality. That means it will be checking for the equal attributes for R and S relation, and it will be projecting the all distinct attribute. What is the meaning? Let's try to understand this with the help of this example. If you want to perform T1 and T2 join, that means T1 join T2, how this query will be written? Like this, that project distinct attribute, that is A, B, C, D, E. We cannot repeat C, D here because it will project only distinct attributes. So project A, B, C, D, E, and what will be condition here? C. We are having C and D. Two attributes are in common, so we'll be checking for T1.C is equal to T2.C. This is what we are doing here, and D is also common, so we'll be checking for T1.D is equal to T2.D. This is this condition. So if these two conditions are satisfying, then only we can join these two relations. So if instead of these two attributes only one attribute is there and it is in common, then also we can join on the basis of that one attribute. Now let's see that if we want to join T1 and T2, how we can do. So T1 join T2. First of all, one thing here is that you can perform cross product, then you will be getting some table. After getting that table, you can check whether these conditions are satisfying. If this condition is satisfying, you can put all those conditions. But unlike cross product, if you perform the cross product, the total attribute will be 4 plus 3, 7. These two will be here and these two will also be there. So in cross product, 7 attribute will be there, but in natural join, we are having only distinct attribute. So here we'll be having 5 attribute, like A, B, C, D, E. So we'll be having these 5 attributes and we are performing on the common basis. That means C and D has to be common. So you can check in the first row, this 6 and this 8 is equal to this 6 and this 8 in T2 table. That means T1.C is equal to T2.C and T1.D is equal to T2.C. That means we can join these two rows. How we can join it? Right? 4, 2, 6, 8. And this 6, 8 is common. So we'll be writing the respective value of E like this. Similarly, again we are having 6, 8 here and 6, 8 here. Again it is common. So we'll be writing 4. 4, 6, 8 and 6, 8 with having E as 4, right? Now you can see that this 4, 8 is common in the T2 double. So we will be writing it as 7, 3, 4, 8, 3. Now you can see that this 7 and 8 is not common in T2 table. That means we cannot pair these two rows together. So the final output will be this. So this will be our final output of the joint condition. Do remember one thing, that in natural joint the quality condition has to be satisfied. So whatever the condition we are talking about here is that in joint we have to satisfy condition, but in natural joint the condition will be of equality by default, right? Now one more thing is that if I am having T1 as A and B, this is another example you can say. So if you are having T1 as A and B, T2 as C and D, then if I perform T1 joined with T2, it will be equivalent as T1 cross product with T2. Why? Because you can see that in these two attributes and in these two attributes there is nothing common. So that means there are no common attributes. So if there are no common attributes, the join will also behave as a cross product. That means natural join equals to cross product if join condition does not exist. So let me write here that if join condition does not exist, this join and cross product results are same. That means they will behave like same. So the output will be same in this particular case. But if there is any common attribute, then we will be checking for equality only. Now let's go with the second join, that is conditional join. So as I told you that in natural join the condition has to be of equality, but in conditional join the condition can be any, whether it can be equality, it can be less than, it can be greater than, and it can be a range also. So in conditional join we represent a small c under the join symbol, it is a suffix. So we are joining as a suffix c, it shows that it is a conditional join. We can write it like this, it will be projecting distinct attribute, select the attribute from R cross product as if this particular condition is satisfied. So it is pretty same as the previous one. The only difference is the condition has been changed, there is no equality condition. So you can see that I am having here an example, R ABC and S is CD. Here C is common attribute. So if we perform the natural join, then we will check the equality condition. But here we are having conditional join. And what is the condition is? Condition is R dot C has to be greater than S dot C. So R dot C, which is this, has to be greater than S dot C. So if we want to perform this specific join operation with this specific condition, it can be as select R dot C, which is greater than S dot C, R cross S. How I can write it directly? You can perform join operation and then you can project all the distinct attribute with this particular case only. Here one thing also here is, if I perform R join S with some condition, one thing is the attribute, all attribute has to be here. That means here it will not show only the distinct attribute, it will show the all attributes including the relation R and S. That means 3 plus 2, 5 attribute has to be there in a conditional join. Now how you can join? Check, is 6 greater than any of these two values? No, 6 is not greater than S of C. This R of C, that is 7, is greater than this. That means we can write this row. This cannot be paired because it is not satisfying this particular condition. So what we can write is, we can write 3, 5, 7, 8, 9. Similarly, if you check for this 6, that R dot C whose value is 6, this 6 is not greater than any of S dot C. That means this is the only record tuple or a row in the result. So it will be the output of this particular conditional join query. Now here you can see one thing, that arity is nothing but number of attributes. is same as cross product. So this is an important statement. This can come in true and false. So here you can see that the arity is same as cross product, while in natural join, if I talk about the natural join, which is this, you can see that arity is different. In cross product, the arity has to be 4 plus 3, 7, but in natural join, the arity is 5 because of distinct. So this is the difference between conditional join and natural join. Now let's move on to the outer join. So outer join has three categories. First is left outer join, second is right outer join, and third is full outer join. So we'll be understanding them with help of example. Don't worry, just stay tuned. So in R, so the left join symbol is same as join symbol, with some two at the top and the bottom, right? So this is the symbol of left outer join, right? So how you can represent left outer join? If you are having bars on the left hand side, then it is left outer join. If it is on the right hand side, it is right outer join. And if this is in right and left both side, then it is full outer join, right? So what is the definition says? The definition says that R left outer join will give us the table with R join as, where some condition will be satisfying with all the records of the left hand side, because we are having bars on left hand side, with all the records of the left hand side who failed the join condition. How? Let's see. I'm having A and B here, right? So I'm applying all these on natural join. See, it can be conditional join also. I will tell you the case where it can be conditional join also. So I'm talking about the natural, so I consider all of them as natural join. Then if I perform R left outer join as, it will give you A, B, C and D, because I'm talking about the natural join, so we'll be having distinct attribute. So A, B, C, D are four distinct attributes in R and S. What will be the values? So we will check for the equality in natural join, right? By default condition is equality in natural join. So this 6 and this 6 is equal. So that means these two rows can be paired. So 2, 4, 6 and 9. This is one row. And now you can see that no other C condition is equal. That means no other condition is satisfying. Sorry, this 6 is equal to this 6. Sorry. So we can also write 4, 3, 6, 9. So this row is done. This row is done. This 7 is not equal to any value of the S dot C. So equality condition has been satisfied. But now we have to take care of this failed condition also. So these two rows satisfy the condition and we wrote it over here. Now we have to take care of the condition, take care of the row which has not satisfied the condition, which is 3, 5, 7. Here we are not having any value of D, so we can write null. Right? So this is the output of R left outer join S. That means we have to include all rows of left particular table. Right, so this way we can perform the left outer join. Similarly, if you talk about the right outer join, we'll be having the join condition along with the records of the right hand side who failed the condition. How? See, here also we'll be having all the distinct attribute because we are working with natural join, and here you can see that these two conditions are matching, so it will be 2, 4, 6, 9, 4, 3, 6, 9, because we are having equality condition satisfied. Now check, go with the S table. S is at right hand side, go to the right table, and in right table check which particular row is not paired. So 8, 5 is not paired with any value, so we'll be putting null as A and B because we are not having any value of A and B for specific 8 and 5 row. So this way we can perform the right outer join, right? I hope you get an idea how this left outer join and right outer join is working. Now let's go with the full outer join as well. In full outer join, we have to take care of both the left and right part. So see, I am having this A and this R and S table. Here I am performing full outer join. So in full outer join, again the attributes will be distinct, that is A, B, C, D, and the values for A, B, C, D will be, first check for equality, that is 6, 6 is matching with this, there will be 2 row, 2, 4, 6, 9, 4, 3, 6, 9. So we have taken care of this and this along with this. Now you can see that in full outer join we have to take care of left table and right table also. So here left table, this record is remaining. Here in right table, this record is remaining. So we will be writing both of these records with null values. So let's go with the left first. So we are having 3, 5, 7 and D as null. So we have completed all the rows of left. Now go with the 8 and 5, which is in right. So 8 and 5 along with the null values. So this way the full outer join works. Now let me tell you one more thing, that these outer joins can be used over conditional join also and over natural join too. So I explained to you this left outer join, right outer join and full outer join using the natural join, but if we are having a conditional join, it can also work. How? Let me explain you. If I want to find out R left outer left outer join with condition S, and let me take the condition as where C is equals to R dot C is greater than S dot C, that means we need to find R left outer join S with condition S R dot C is greater than S dot C. So what are the table? Let me show you the values of the table. Just one second. So this is A and B table. So here we are talking about the conditional join. This is conditional join. So here we are working with the conditional join. So I told you how to work with natural join. Now this outer join has to work with conditional join. So in conditional join, I already told you that the attributes will not be distinct. That means the arity will be same as cross product. So what can be the arity over here? Arity will be A, B, C, C, D. No distinct attributes because we are working with conditional join this time. Right? Now, R dot C has to be greater than S dot C. So you can see that R dot C, 6 is not greater than any of these values. 7 is greater than 6. That means we will be writing 3, 5, 7 and 6, 9. So this is the only row, only tuple which is having a greater value of C as compared to S, right? Now these two rows failed the condition. So here we are talking about the left outer join. So in left table we have to check for the failed row. So these two rows failed the condition, so we will be taking care as 2, 4, 6 and put these both values as null this time. Similarly for 3, 6, null and null. So this way we can work with both conditional join and natural join. So I hope you got an idea about the join operation in relational algebra. So this is an important basic. In the next video we will be seeing the join queries, that if we are having a statement, how we can write it in a relational algebra query using the symbol. So if you found this video useful, like this video, share it with your friends, comment your feedback in the comment section and I will read it and I will try to improve everything. And one more thing is, if you are not connected with me on my Facebook page and Facebook group, you can go in the description. You can check those links in the description also. Thanks for supporting. Keep supporting. कीप लर्निंग, हैव अ ग्रेट डे।